Good evening to one and all present over here. I'm requesting Mr. Nitish Bhij also to please switch on your video. Mr. Anand Babu has already joined with us from ICT Academy. So with all of your permission, let me start our program. Good afternoon to all the presenters, Mr. Anand Babu from ICT Academy, Mr. Nitish Bhij, who is our resource person today, also a trainer from ICT Academy, and all my beloved participants. It is indeed a starting of a journey that Geeta Ratan International Business School has started as a member academy of ICT Academy, and this is their first activity which they are doing jointly. So I am delighted that from ICT Academy, Mr. Anand Babu is with us, and we heartily welcome him, sir. Geeta Ratan International Business School, established in the year 2004. It is approved by All India Council for Technical Education for different technical programs, and Bar Council of India for its law programs. And this institute is affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. Geeta Ratan International Business School has been instrumental since 2004 in developing its students, faculty members, and gradually since 2012 onwards, they are also started different programs under staff development program, because Geeta Ratan International Business School feels it that there is an immense need to develop all of its resources. With this idea, different types of staff development program has been conducted in many a times in past. Now, with the association of ICT Academy, this is the first endeavor where we are going to start with Microsoft Office, which is one of the best platform on which almost all the staff members used to work. We just have taken a poll and we have seen that 83% of today's participants are using Microsoft Office tools. So this is their one of the activity in everyday work life where they are using Microsoft Office. We want to inform some specific area today that with that knowledge, the staff members may get benefit in their future days activities, because Microsoft is also developing its different tools and platforms day by day. So with this idea, we have developed today's staff development program. And now I will request Mr. Anand Babu to please tell us a brief about ICT Academy, about its objective, how they are helping different educational institutes nationwide to develop the different stature of the staff members as well as faculty members. Sir, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for the warm welcome. And I represent ICT Academy, which is an initiative government of India under the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So this is our first program, as mentioned by Professor Ghosh. So this is our first program we are doing with Geeta Ratan. And we are looking for so many opportunities and to work collaboratively with GIPS for many such initiatives. To talk about ICD Academy, as I said, it's a non-for-profit autonomous society. When you talk about a non-for-profit autonomous society, there are a lot of skill development agencies that have been initiated by government under their various platform. But they never found anything which can cater to all sort of stakeholders in an academic circle. So when they found this organization in the year 2010, in fact, 2009 to be very precise, 2010 only we started operation, 2008 we started, and 2009 we started operation. So we have traveled around 11 years of journey. So this is a non-for-profit autonomous society where under a public-private partnership model, it has been started. The government and the industry, they came together in order to serve the academic institutions across the country. That was the first and foremost objective. And to the point, they started this initiative to train the higher education teachers on the latest technological advancements. That was the objective when 2009 it was given a thought. So we were traveling, and whatever the government have given as a project has been successfully completed. In the year 2015, Niti Aayog, which is the highest planning commission body in India, have identified ICT Academy as one of the best practices implemented by Government of India, where they have featuring ICT Academy in the last 5 years of their how the future India is going to be, their particular book. So it has been circulated to across all the states through the chief ministers, because the chief ministers of those states are the people who will be receiving this. So in that, Niti Aayog have endorsed ICT Academy that they should start their operation not only for one state, to across all the states. So from since 2015, we are operating pan India, and we don't want not only work with academic institutions, because academic institutions are the beneficiary, but the benefit has to be come from some other place. Those are the other two stakeholders. One is the government, and another one is the corporate. When you talk about the government, you name any agencies, when you talk about AACT, NAC, NBA, or UGC. So we've been closely working with them. In fact, we trained around 17,000 students for AACT approved institutions across northeastern states under AACT project. And now we are going to train another 5,000 students in Jammu and Kashmir for AACT approved institutions. So under UGC, we part of the steering committee of the various programs. Like that, we worked with various government agencies, and the government, whenever they wanted to implement any program, so we identify the institutions, especially our member institutions, to be the beneficiary. On the other side, the corporates, you name any corporate in the world, the top corporates in the world, the product companies, I'm not talking about the service companies, the product companies, especially the IT-enabled services companies, ICT Academies were part of it. You name CTS, TCS, Hexaware, you name Oracle, Salesforce, or IBM. You name any product or service company, the top companies are with ICT Academy. We partnered with 99 organizations. So I wanted to make sure one thing. These two stakeholders, whatever they give, at the end of the day, the beneficiaries are the academic institutions, either the faculty members or the students of those particular institutions of ICT Academy. So ICT Academy currently serving around 4,500 higher education institutions across the country. And we touch upon every day a faculty or a student on various other formats, one through like how we are doing it right away. So we have other formats like FDP programs. And we trained around 48,000 teachers in the last 11 years. And we trained around 1,95,000 students in the last 11 years or so through ICT Academy. And the touch base is increasing every day. So this is what ICT Academy is all about. So with this word, I would like to conclude my points, what ICT Academy is all about. I hope I didn't took more than 5 minutes of time. So I wish all the participants to enjoy the session. Mr. Nitish, who is one of our very, very important person in the training and development team. So he is with us today as a resource person. So I wish all the participants to make sure that you are attending the session and you are getting benefited out of this. So wish you all the best once again. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. With your crisp and very informative session with what ICT Academy can do us for the futures also. Now, let me coming to our today's presenter, Mr. Nitish Bhij. Mr. Nitish is a master of engineering holder on communication field, and he is also training and development. He has worked as associate with Canara HSBC OBC Life Insurance, as well as a data analyst in Artha Creation. He has extensive knowledge on providing transfer training to professional students, professors of various technologies, Python, R, data science, big data, machine learning, all his area of command. Currently, he is working with ICT Academy as a technical trainer and in training and research department of the organization. We welcome Mr. Nitish in this SDP, and let we hand over this session to you to deliver your lectures to our staff members who have participated here.
Got it, sir. Thank you, sir, for sharing this opportunity. And I hope, like today, the Excel part that I'm going to cover, I will be touching all those important topics. So thank you for joining today's session. It's the afternoon part. I hope everyone have done their lunch. So I just need some energetic responses in the chat window. If you can, please help me out. So I have actually, for this session only, I have taken two Excel files. And from that two Excel files, I will be doing multiple tasks. It can include your VLOOKUPs, how to do a transform, HLOOKUPs, how to do small mathematical operations in each column, how to check the data type of each column, and how to make charts. Actually, that is the most important part, how to make charts. So in next 40 minutes, I will be doing two Excel files. So let's go to the technical part directly. So I'm sharing a screen. Please let me please confirm if it is visible to everyone or not. Is it visible to everyone? Anoop sir, if you can confirm if it is visible. I cannot see the chat now.
It is visible. Sir, just can your voice be more loud? Hello. Yes.
Is it okay now?
Yeah. It is fine. It is perfect now.
Okay, sir. So let's say you have this type of Excel file. I have created this Excel file for your department-wise section. Since you are all academicians, faculties, working in different departments. So if you are getting this type of information about your students, nowadays, since we have all gone online, so we all know, like, we are taking online classes as well as online papers. And in the meanwhile, while we are doing online papers, we make some unique ID for the students so that we can identify them by the end of the session or paper. It can be a combination of some characters or numerical letters. It can be entirely numerical letters, or it can be pure characters. So in case, in this scenario, I am taking a username. If you want to create a username for a student so that he can perform a task, a small quiz on your platform. So how to do that? This student data set, or in short, it is my ICT data set that I've taken. It's name, gender, departments, address basically falls to the region, either Delhi or Chennai, mobile number, salary, what we are getting, and experience, how much we have. It's just a dummy data. And same way, you can also have the Excel data. So the task that we need to perform is these few: how to generate the username, how to look for the pivot table. I have written the pivot table values, test department versus salary, how we look at that, and how to check minimum operations, what is the minimum or maximum value inside the integer columns. It can be basic functions also, it can be high functions also. So I hope you enjoy all those tasks. So let's take this master data. Now, if I just copy and paste it, I've created one of the Excel sheet. And there you can see a username is by default is created by if you have pasted all data in one sheet. Now, if I just create another one, let's say I am taking for Anoop sir. He is a male, he is in HR, Delhi, and some dummy number. It should be 10 characters at least. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Some salary, let's say he's earning 1 lakh a month. I hope, sir, you actually earn this much. And experience, let's say he's having 5 years experience. And by the time I'm just finished filling the data, a username is created. And we can just drag drop all those formulas to the end of the sheet. And you can keep including or inserting more and more rows. So how did I make this formula? And how to actually copy and paste this section? Sometimes it happens like you're copying and pasting it. And because of that, the whole format is changed. Let's say I have this data also by the end of this file. Now you can see it's a different format. It's not in such table for boundaries it is having. And if I copy and paste it directly somewhere, so you can see the format is changed. How to make a file where you can actually keep the format intact? Although the formula is working on the left side, I'm getting the username as per that formula I have written, but how to correct it? So what to do? Each time you're copying the data, let me delete it. Each time you're copying the data and you are actually pasting it in the file or sheet. For me, it is generate username. If you're pasting inside the sheet that contains some formula that can generate results on the basis of the data that you're adding in the sheet. So let me highlight this one as green, or let's say it is something blue. Stuck between, let me wait for it. Yeah, now it is there. So let me, I have highlighted where the formula is written, and this is the data that you need to do copy and paste special. So I'm deleting the whole data right now. So the same shortcut for copy is Control C. I'm copying it. I'm going to the sheet, generate username, and I will be doing paste special. And how to do the paste special in the entire data set? You can go just put the cursor or cell, highlight that part where you start wanting to pasting the data, and then go above the menu and you can see paste. Here you can see various options are there. So one of the option is paste special. This one, paste values. So if I do it, let me copy it again. I think it's taking a little more time. I didn't realize like why is it heating up right now, because the data has been inserted. So let's do Shift F9. Okay. There is the data. If sometime you are stuck, like I was stuck right here in the middle, I didn't expect like this will happen. So if you are stuck while copying and pasting a huge amount of data to a new Excel sheet, you can refresh it. And how to refresh it? You can just press the shortcut Shift plus F9. I am writing it Shift plus F9. This is the shortcut to refresh it. So if you're pasting a huge amount of data and at the same time it is not visible to you at that particular moment, you can just do shift plus F9. It will refresh that particular Excel sheet and you will get the result. So since I have done paste special, so how to do paste special? If the data is copied, that is if the data is available in your clipboard, right now I have copied it. So this button will be activated and you can perform is paste values, and here is the paste values. And then you will get all those values inserted inside the cell. The format will not be changed. And if by mistake you have done this part, I'm just copying this one. And if you paste directly here, you can see the format of the file changed. So just to avoid it, do paste special. And how I created this formula, if you can see, it is just the concatenation of your own name in lowercase and the right side of the mobile number. And how many digits I have taken from the mobile number? It's 5. You can also get something from your username. You can also generate with the help of the email IDs or some code if you are having, like a student has joined in the month of July. So the code that you can use is 07 and the year is 2020. So that thing can be common. So what I have done, I have taken empty cells and I have written all those formulas one by one. So first is left side of, you can see the left has been there and I'm taking this value name. And how many letters from the name I'm taking? Only 3. So put comma and 3. If anywhere you want to check the syntax also, or want to get the help, just click on the keyword like left. So once you click on the keyword, an Excel help section will pop up. I think it is not visible on the screen because I have shared only Excel file. Excel help is another sheet that was opened in front of me. So once you do it, it will open on your screen also and press enter. So you can see that left 3 characters are taken from the name. The next part I did was lower the data. So I have done lower. You can combine both of them also. With practice, you will get all those formulas. And the next I have done is get the right part of the mobile number. And how many digits from the right side I have taken? It can be 4, 5, depending on the length of the username you want to create. I have taken 5. So this is the concatenation operations I performed between both of them. So it is actually something like this, concatenate. The very first keyword is the name, comma, and the next part is the mobile number. That's it. So this was the username I have created on the left side. Although I have shown you different steps of the formula, but here I have written the formula in one line. Concatenate left side of the part. If I just click it, you can check for all the colored cells. So let me show you. Let me delete all this. So if I just highlight it, you can see I have taken lower to change the whole casing of the string into lowercase. And then inside it, I have done concatenation. And what I'm concatenating is left side of the name. So B5. B5 is this section name. I am taking 3 characters from there. And right of F5. F5 is the section for mobile number. So in mobile number, I'm taking the 5 characters. So the whole formula I've written in one cell. And then we can drag drop the formula. You can drag drop the formula like this. So it will automatically be dropped to the lower cells. So whenever you want to extend more, you just select the cell. There is small dot that appears on the screen and you have to just click it and extend it to the bottom and it will be extended. So if anywhere I write the formula, let's say your college name, I'm writing it's a Gitranjal. And some mobile number I'm writing for it is something 111111. And now a username has been created over there. So in this way, you can just paste special the whole data on this section, and you will be able to create the username for each one. So same application in your case is like getting the student username for specific test, or to get this stored in the database so that it is valid for the entire period of his life. It can be 3 years, 5 years, once he enters your college. And the pivot tables. So pivot tables are how to take a pivot table. First, highlight the table you want to do pivot action. So this is the small table I want to do pivot action. You just have to go to the insert part. In insert, click the pivot table and it will ask you, is it a new worksheet or existing? If you put existing worksheet, then the new pivot table will be inserted in the same page. But if it is new, so in the same Excel file, which my name is employee data, in that only the new sheet will be created. So you can see a new sheet is there. Let me write down pivot table. So I will be sharing this file with you as well as the next file. And if you want to check pivot table, you have to just select the column names you want to have. And with respect to those column names, what value you want to look at it. So my data was like this. Let's say I want to check in HR, I mean in each department, how much total salary is being given. So go back, select the pivot table, and it will be displayed on the right side what fields you want to insert. If you have not selected this part, for example, I am just putting my cursor here. So there is no actions available. You have to first select it, the pivot table, and the text box will be appearing on the right side displaying all the relevant options. So I want to check department, and in that department, how much total salary is being given. So click salary. Let me increase the font size. So here, so in this part, I can see maximum salary is accommodated to IT trainers. Then comes almost HR and sales receives equivalent amount of salaries per month, and admin receives the minimum. And now if I want to visualize the result also, select the pivot table and go to the insert, and there you can see all the charts. Let's say I want to have pie chart. Select the pie chart. It's a 2D I want. You can also have a 3D. So hold, actually it's again stuck. It never happened to me actually. While I'm doing the session, it gets stuck. But maybe I'm using Webinar Jam. Might be one of the consequences I have to face. Because I am already on the master data, I can also not see it, but you can see the values are changing on the side. So it is right there. Now I have got it. So pivot table going back, now it is there. So once you get this type of charts, you can always go and add more animations or different perspective how to visualize the chart. To do that, go to the design and you can select various formats of charts you want to have. For me, I just want to have small part. It's like compact layout. So let me see layout 2, layout 1. This. Yeah. So this was the compact or best fit. So here each of the values is shown, admin, HR, IT trainer and sales. With respect to that, the amount that was accumulated or given to each department is shown right here in their particular section. You can go and have a 2D also. It's getting stuck in the middle, so I have to skip this part of chart. You can all play around it. So the task we have performed is like generate username. Yes, we have done. How to do filter? So filter is like you have highlighted this cell and you have a drop down options available there. So you have to go to the data under the menu, go inside the data tab, and there you will see the filter. Once you collect the filter, you can see on each column, the header of the column, your drop down values are available. So click on the drop down value. You can select, uncheck or check each one of them and get the relevant data. So this is for particular Delhi. I can even copy it and paste it somewhere like this. And I will have the whole data for Delhi. So let's say I'm pasting here only. And let me off the filter. Let me switch off the filter. So this was the data that was containing Delhi and Chennai. And below is the table where I'm having only Delhi part. So you can say like it plays a very heavy role for filters to get the relevant data. Same that we have in SQL. So I can do multiple filters also. Let's say in Delhi, I want to take only HR department. So you just copy it and paste anywhere on the below. So if I just switch off the filter now, you can see the relevant data is right there available on my screen. So you can do multiple filter actions and get your relevant data and then do some analysis or work towards it. You can plot a chart. So this chart, if I follow it entirely for the Delhi location. So this time I can go for inside Delhi, HR department, females and males, how much salary is allocated to each gender partition. Inside this also, if you want to do something, so if you want to check inside each department, how much salary is allocated to male or female, you can click the gender and you can get the idea. So it's just like a sectional view. Now I have each department wise, under department wise, each gender wise partition. Instead of gender, you can also go for the gender address. So let's say I want to get only address and gender. So in this part, first the bifurcation is done on the basis of region. Under each region, what salary is allocated to each department? You can even change it right there and it will be changing the values. You can see here. Firstly, I was having my region. First I have my department, then I have partition region wise. But if you just switch the part here, if I'm dragging it to the department below address. So first priority is given to address. Under address, you can do under this region, what department is getting what salary, you can work towards it. So these are very few actions I can perform right now with this short data set. Let's go with the another one. Let me save it. I'm again stopping the screen sharing and opening another Excel file. This Excel file now contains the data about the e-commerce customers. So same way someone can ask you let me share it with you. The Excel file, yeah, this one. Suppose this is the Excel file, and someone asks you about your own data, that I'm giving you a student username, email ID, mobile number, anything, and retrieve his information. Give me the relevant information. To have a look at the data set, let me help you with it. This was the data set of customer e-commerce, its email IDs, region, avatar or a profile picture he is using, how much time he has spent. It's like with respect to particular hours since the time he is a merchant or since the time he is a customer on the platform, how much hours he has spent and number of years he is being with that particular e-commerce company, and the yearly amount business he has given or she has given to the relevant e-commerce company. So what I have done here, you can see there are so many relevant data available, but out of these data, I just want to retrieve the information for region, membership years, and yearly amount spent. And I have to just put the email ID. Once I have email ID is put up on the part, and for that, a VLOOKUP operation is performed, getting me the whole data. So it contains of two tasks. First, I have done some transformation. That is transform of metrics, if you have heard. Whatever is in the horizontal section, get to the vertical. And if it is under vertical, get to the horizontal. So transform operation, it is called. And from that transform, I have taken only these relevant data. So let me help you with the particular formulas, what I have done. So I will not be coloring this part. I'm just writing it. Tell me your email ID. And I will be just writing my email ID here. So let's putting a dot, dot, dot here. I want to get retrieve what I have done. First, retrieve all the relevant information. So I've done transform action. And how we do the transform? First, count the total number of values you want to have. So right now total are 5. So same way, if there are total 5 columns, so we need to have 5 rows to store this data. So I just want to have 5 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Select all those cells. So how I selected it? Using shift and arrow, down arrow, I'm selecting it. Shift and down arrow, or you can go below, shift and above arrow. So you have to particularly press the shift, select all the cells, and then leave the button. I'm writing the formula. It is equal to, yeah, directly write the formula now. Transpose, you can see on the screen, transpose is there. And after transpose, you can see it is displaying an array. So what is an array for me is all these column names. I'm selecting all those columns. So on the address bar, you can see the formula transpose. Then what I have done, transpose all the values that contain from B1 to F1, B1 to F1. So press enter. It is not showing because I have to write formula from the starting. But there was a mistake of starting from the below. No problem. Let's start from the top. So the equal to section shall come on the top side. Transpose. And what I'm transposing? All those values. Press enter. Sorry, not enter. That was the mistake I was doing. Okay. So it is not enter. It is 3 buttons. You please write down those 3 buttons. Once you have selected the relevant cells, you have to press Control, Shift, and Enter. All those 3 buttons simultaneously. Don't do like first press Control, then unpress it and press Shift, then remove your finger from the Shift and press Enter. All those things has to be done simultaneously. So I will be pressing Control, Shift, and then Enter. Control, Shift, Enter. Now it is there. So you can see all those values are there. At the same time, please see on the other side also that here we have values that are shown on the address bar. But if I see here, there are formulas. So if I want to have the values at the same place, just copy it. Same thing, paste values. So if any cell is having formulas, only values will be left behind. Now you can see we have only values, avatar, average, something like this. And what values I was having? Region, membership year, and yearly amount spent. So I'm deleting my avatar, the whole row, and average time. Cut and paste here. Now I will be writing my data over here. What features I want to extract? So this time I have to use my VLOOKUP. So in the VLOOKUP, what we have to do? First, we have to take the input value. So you can also check the syntax. It takes the lookup value. It is your input value what you want to retrieve data for. So I want to retrieve the data for the cell this O5. So once I some email ID is written in O5, for that I have to display all the value region. So my lookup value is O5, comma. Now it is asking for the table array. So table array is this one, email ID, and the whole table. Before we proceed, you should check for the region, column, position number. So first column is email, second is region. So I have to write down second, comma two. You can check above also. First, the lookup value was O5. Then the array or table that I'm taking is e-commerce customer, this page, and the section is from A1 to F501. So A1 is this cell, and 501 will be at the end of this F column. Then I have pressed 2 to highlight region, as email ID is my first column and region is the second column. Then put comma and 0. 0 is for exact match, not the approximate match. So right now nothing is there, but if I just copy this email ID only and paste here. So you can see the region has popped up on the screen. The next value, what I have done, I'm just copying the whole values. Either you can copy from the cell, or you can highlight the cell and you can copy from the address bar. Copy, and I'm pasting the formula below. Control V, Control V. I just need to change the column number with respect to the email ID. So region was lying at column number 2. You can check again here. With respect to email ID, my region was column 2. My membership is 345. And yearly amount is 6. So I will just write down 5 and 6 there. Either you can write inside the cell or you can write in the address bar. So I'm writing 5 here. Press enter. And now for next one, I'm just writing 6 here. And press enter. So you can see all those values that are displayed in my colored region are present on the right side also. Next thing what I've done is just the coloring. You can all perform it using the designing that is present on the home screen. This is paint button and this font color. That's it. So again, I'm explaining the VLOOKUP. Some of you, if you are not aware, firstly, you have to check for the VLOOKUP value for which you want to display a output value against region. My input value is 05, which is this email ID. Against this email ID, my data is taken from the table e-commerce customers, which is the sheet name, and then this table whole thing I have to select. So you can use your mouse to select it like this, or you can use your shift and plus upside and downside arrows. So those things I have done to select it. And the next was the column name, position number, and then zero. Please remember the last one is zero because we need exact value. Sometimes it happens like the numerical data is there or your username, this one, the input value can have something missing like this. It is not Hotmail, it is HOmail. So with respect to that, I don't want exact match. I want the false match. I can write one and it can look for the similar values against it. It is not exact true, but it has just used that username and wherever it is very close to the match, so it has put it. So right now I'm getting different result. So for that reason, it shall not happen. It is an error that I'm performing. So I have to do exact match here. Press zero. And for above it, write down Hotmail. So I'm getting the exact values. So VLOOKUP, just to think of like VLOOKUP will only work if your input column reference, that is here email ID was my input column, it should present on the extreme left side. If anywhere it is present inside the data set, let's say it is present right here. So now I will not be able to get the region. You can again check it, retrieve data. And there are errors because it take reference from email ID and then it looks for the column that lies forward to that particular column. So it will always look towards or forward to forward or going towards the right. So to avoid it, you can do one thing. If this is the case somewhere that email ID is present here, so take a copy of the data. Don't manipulate the original data. And cut it and somehow manipulate your new data as per your desired conditions. So now I'm getting the data. So the task was first VLOOKUP. Here it is done. Check type of cell. How to check the data type of each cell? So the keyword comes is like equal to type. And then you can select the cell that you want to check it. For example, I want to check for this avatar. It is coming as 2. Why it is coming as 2? I think it will also be not displayed on my screen. If I click the type button, let me share it, how it looks if it is available. So sharing. Yeah. So I'm sharing this part. This is the help section that will pop up if you touch that type button. So you can see here, number, if a value is 1, it means number. If it is 2, it means text. So my avatar was the name, something blue, orange, tomato. So that is a text. If it is 4, less than logical value or error or arrays. So that way you can perform various tasks over here while checking the type of the data. The next task that I have saved here is for, so this is also done. How to check blank cells? We have done the transpose also. Count of avatar, these are a pivot table. Count blank cells and small operations. For example, if you want to check the maximum number of year, membership year, one cell performed. So I'm just writing equal to max. And after that, you have to just select the array. So this is the array. I'm using shift and upside button to select the everything. And press enter once the cell is highlighted. So under that, my 6 is the highest. Now, if you want to check the previous one, just copy it and paste it here and it will give you the value with respect to the previous column. What if I want to check the next one? Copy the formula and paste it in the next cell. So this time getting the maximum business that a person has given since he is joined with the e-commerce company. Same way, if you want to find the minimum, so you write min and select the array. For me, array is the particular column, so I'm selecting it and copying it and pasting here and pasting here. So the minimum business that I have received from yearly amount is 25,667, and the minimum year, that is zero, that a person is just a new joining on the e-commerce company. How to check for the blank cells? If your data is having blank values, sometimes it happens that the student has not filled the address correctly. Although your columns is having three, I mean your table is having three columns that are specially allocated to the address. It can be line one, line two, or line three, and the student has not filled line three. So what to do in such situations? So how to actually check if the data is having blank values? So for that, I just said and created some blank values here. I'm just going to the bottom of the data set. If not bottom, you can also insert new cells above, and you can write down the formula count, and there is a blank. So here is the shortcut, count the number of blanks. If I do it, count blank and select the range. For me, range starts from this part, the whole section of email ID. So I have to select everything. It will take time because now it is having email blank values. I have got to the bottom and press enter. So you can see the email IDs. I have 14 students who have not filled the email IDs correctly. Copy it and paste it in the next one. You will get the blank values with respect to the next column. So I have 4 blank values in region. Copy it and paste it in the next one, avatar. Then average time, membership, and then yearly amount. So only first 3 columns have blank values. Next 3 don't have the blank. So this is one of the way you can check if any value is left untouched or it is not filled by the student. The last one is how to make this part chart. For this, same thing. To make a pivot, first you have to select the table. So my table is this one. Go to the insert and pivot table, new sheet. Now I have to create a pivot between each region and across each region. What is the yearly amount I have received from the each region? So select the pivot, your region. It is right there. And yearly amount. So by default, it will give you all the information. Let me increase the size. Sometimes it might happen like you want to count how many customers are there in these regions also. So we can go reverse way. So instead of it, yearly amount, let's drag the region only to the values. So I have to drag it. If you select it, so based on the intelligence what Microsoft Pivot has already have, it will allocate each one to the 4 regions. So right now I want to check the count, so I can also see how many people are giving business as per different regions. So I have max 47 from Indore, that is the maximum I can see, and 32, it is from Lucknow and Ahmedabad. That is the minimum I can see, yes. So this way you can either go for the count, or you can just remove it. How to remove it? Click it and just go. It will be vanished. And I want to insert yearly amount, click it and drag here. It will be right there. Now let's have the pivot between them. Select the table, go to the insert and my pie chart. This time let's check 2D. I think again it will take time to come. Pie chart. Shift F9. Yeah, so I got the pivot. This time I want to check the yearly amount spent with respect to each value. Go to the design. You can take out any color. I'm taking this color for now. And you can also change color from this part. You can give different perspective. It is just hue and saturation. And the last you can have is
Mr. Nitish, I think now the screen has stopped. So can you 1 second stop sharing and back to this?
Screen has stopped. It is not visible. The pivot table.
No.
Okay. Is it visible now?
Yeah, now it is visible.
Okay. So I was saying, if you have this pivot table, once you have from this pivot table, I have created this chart. So first I selected this pivot table values. I went to this insert that I opened this pie chart. I have selected 2D. Let me delete it and get to the original one. Okay. So it is just taking a lot of time. I'm not able to understand why it has never happened in this maybe webinar situation. I'm not aware of it actually. Sorry about it.
Sir, it is due to video and this one going simultaneously. That is why it is taking so much time.
Let me then stop my video actually, if it is okay. So in this part now, what last step I have performed here, went to the design. Always go to the design. If you have selected anything, go to the design. Select the appropriate colors you want to have for your particular chart. And then under layout, I want those numbers, salary numbers, to be inserted everywhere. So you can see here, everything is present. So let's check it out, like in such situation. So in this way, you can manipulate the data the way you want. And even you want, you can remove it, the total, you can select the plus sign here. There is a legend values available. It is specifically for XY axis. Your chart title, if you want to have, and what you want to have, you can change it. And then we have some more format or coloring options. It is right there. You can change it using the brush, or you can send another format of colors to it. So in this way, you can perform multiple tasks here. And another step I wanted to add is the last one. If in pivot table, you want to have another column. Previously in the student data set, I was only having region wise bifurcation. What if I want to have different column here? You just click any other column. Let's say I'm taking avatars and I want avatar to be in the column. So now you can see in this particular column, each avatar under the region, each avatar, how much business it is giving from particular region. So Alice Blue profile picture, who is using from Mumbai, it is giving approximately 47,000 business, and from Patna it is giving 46,000 business. But if you just change this value from left to right, you can just get a different view for it. And now if I just put it right here, on the value section, you can see here now I'm getting count of it. So you can just play around here. It's very beautiful, it's very easy once you get hang of it. So now I'm getting count. From Ahmedabad, I can say like I have total 32%, and 32% has given me a total business of 16 lakh 18 thousand something. And from Mumbai, I have total 41 customers, and 41 customers has given me a business of around 20 lakh plus. So in this way, you can perform multiple operations. And if you just want to remove anything, just click it, drag it anywhere, and release your mouse button. That's it. Everything will be removed. So one of the picture that I've created is in this way. It's a 3D picture. You can also create it. I will share this Excel file so that you can take it or use it as a reference work. We have performed all those tasks, how to check blank values, check minimum, maximum, make pie chart. And there is also one operation making charts between different columns. So if I want to print chart between any of those two columns, you cannot do in this way. Like I select the whole table, then under insert, I will go to chart and I will make a chart for two columns. It doesn't work like this. To make a chart, you just need to have two columns. So you have to first select your columns, paste it inside any of the cells. I created a charts build cell, these two columns, and I'm getting the particular picture or graph for it. So just an idea, under this membership years, like once the person who is around 1 year, 0 to 1 year, who is old with the e-commerce company, he can give me a business around 25,000 also, and a maximum of 50,000. We can also go and change the switch rows and columns. You can go and play around here. The maximum of data set is 2255. Okay. So I can even change the chart type. It can be bar graph we can use. Let's say I have a bar graph. So all these options are available to you. You can look forward to it. But you can use my data set as your reference and can work with different examples. So I hope you got understanding about this basic operations that we have in pivot table. And if you have any doubt, I'm open to it. Let's start part.
I have already asked the participants that whether they have any question, they may put it in the chat. You just type in your chat. If you have any question.
Can we share the files directly in the webinar then?
Yes, sir. You go to, there is files button. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
In the left pane, there is files. You click over there and add a new file. You have to assign any name of the file,
yes sir,
whatever it be, and just upload. It will be shared to everyone.
So the very first file I have this part, e-commerce. So I uploaded the file. I hope, is it visible to everyone, sir?
Just a second.
I have uploaded both files. Now what to do? Share.
Share. Yes, sir.
Sharing. Is it now?
Yes, it is now working. Both the file 1 and 2 is sharing.
Okay, sir. So that's the main important thing that I can share with every participant. They can use it for reference purpose.
I think there is no more questions from the participant side.
Okay.
And we also have come to the time also up to the end part. So Mr. Nitish, can you please repeat blank cell count? One question is there, sir. Can you please repeat blank cell count?
Okay, Parveen sir, it is nothing like if you're having a data set that is having null values. the values that were not inserted by the student or any other employee or any other person. So in such situation, your data is irrelevant if you are doing any analysis. So to check the relevance of the data, we can just check how much blank cell it is having. And the shortcut to check the blank cell is write the keyword count blank and inside that pass on the array. That array can be your row or it can be your entire column. Once you select the entire column, you will get the values, how many blank cells it is having. We can also protect. Under data, we have options protect. We can protect any sheet with a password. You will all find this answer under the section data. Let me open the Excel file. Just view, it is opening. Yeah, now it is opened. Let me share it. So suppose this is the sheet I want to protect. You can go for either protect sheet or protect workbook. Select any one of them and check the entire sheet. Select unlock cells, format cells, whatever you want to check it out. And then you can write down the password to protect it. And for workbook also, select the workbook, select password, and now it will be protected.
Nitish sir, actually the question is protect a cell.
Any cell, it is not.
I have answer. May I?
Yes, sir. Let me show you.
So basic concept is to protect a cell. First, you have to unprotect the whole sheet. And then click on a particular cell and then once again protect the sheet. This is the two-way process. I got it from one YouTube video that if you want to protect a particular cell, then you first go and protect that particular sheet, making a particular cell selected. And then unprotect it, you will get that particular cell as a protected.
Let me show it again. I thought it was already open. Let me show that thing. It comes with different, actually. Let me actually do the entire screen, then it might be possible.
Yeah.
So this is the one I was saying.
If yeah.
You click anywhere, you protect the sheet. In that part, whatever you want to protect, you can check it up. The proper
check box. No, sir, the locked cells, look, that one, select locked cells, that should be unprotect first.
This one.
Then.
Select unlocked cells.
I think both you have to uncheck. Then you just check on the whole sheet, then only that cell will be protected. Let me see, because I also have done once it one.
Yeah, so it is now protected actually. I cannot delete anything. So now if I want to do it, I have to unprotect it. So write down 1, 2, 3 and now it is there. If I delete it, cannot, but sorry, it is a pivot table. So let me practice it right here. Mail, protect sheet, 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I cannot do it. So I cannot, it can only be protected sheet. I have to look forward to it. What exact option is available.
Okay, we will answer the participants afterwards. But it is possible. I have one solution. Previously, I have done it once.
Even now, I cannot select the cell actually. So this is the way for locked cells actually. So you can play around here, select unlocked cells. So all those things we can do here. Any other question that we have? Can we perform? Protect the cell layers?
Both, I think they actually want to mention that one, that part. That protect the cell. Their question is how they can only protect that particular cell, and it is possible. So Mr. Nitish, we almost have come to the end of this session, wonderful session, and I hope almost all the participants have got a good input from your session, so that they can in their future days apply all those knowledge they have taken today. With this, once again, I am extending our heartiest welcome, both ICT Academy and Mr. Nitish, in for his wonderful session. And I am also sharing my gratitude to all the participants who have taken part wonderfully in this event and successfully put their questions, take part in the different polls. And we are also thankful to ICT Academy administrators and the management of Gitaratan International Business School to allow us to conduct such a wonderful session for the staff members who are working at different places all over the globe to get some knowledge on it. Mr. Nitish, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Your video is off, so please, if you can, your video is off. I'm not getting your video.
Right now, sir, your side is connectivity.
Okay, maybe. So thank you all. Let we now close down our session today. Thank you, Mr. Nitish.
Thank you, Anup, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, every attendees, for taking the session on Saturday. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Meet you next time. Thank you.
So thank you all the participants. Let we close down our session.